Hey, this is Galloping Gabe. We're still here live from the Maryland Film Festival. The only film festival that is hipper than any other film festival, only nobody else knows it. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We just talked to one of the hippest actors hanging out around here who's starring in Stingray Sam. But guess who we got now? We got the director of Stingray Sam. And we're going to talk to him, and we're going to find out what makes him tick and what's going on. We're right here in the filmmaker's sauna at the Maryland Film Festival in Baltimore, Maryland, live, coming to you. So we've got Corey McAbee. Hi, Corey. How are you doing?
Very good, very good. Having a good time here at the sauna. So you just spoke with Michael Wiener. Michael Wiener, he's a wonderful actor, and we had a great time working together on Stingray Sam. He's plays one of the scientists. He plays the smarmy scientist in episode 3. Stingray Sam is it's a feature film, but it's constructed in serial format. So
episodic.
It's episodic. So there's 6 episodes. Each one's approximately 11 minutes.
Really?
Yeah, and each one has a beginning, middle, and end. And each one, it's a musical, so each one has a featured musical track.
Now, first of all, is he a singer as well?
Actually, he is a singer. He just gave me his CD.
So does he sing in your movie?
He does sing in the movie, but it came as a surprise to me that he was able to do such a good job. So
great.
I think he does a good job.
So he's actually a cameo.
Yeah, he does a cameo.
Or he's a guest star.
He's a guest star, yeah.
So there are other people that are going to be in this that we may need to talk to later.
Actually, everybody's left. Our director of photography, who also plays one of our characters, was here at the screening and has left. His whole family was here. So
this is a feature film?
It's a feature film. Part of the inspiration for it was I was commissioned by the Sundance Film Festival in 2007.
One of the other film festivals that's really not as hip as the Baltimore, Maryland Film Festival, right here in downtown Baltimore, and we're here live at the VIP Filmmakers Sauna. Go on.
Yeah, so, anyway, they it's true. This is actually a really wonderful and fun film festival. I've been running around from film to film with the other filmmakers, and we've been having a great time. Just the whole vibe of the festival has just been a wonderful, pleasant experience. I was commissioned to make a film for mobile phones, and I was commissioned in December of 2006, and the film was presented in,
back when they were still called mobile phones as opposed to wireless phones.
In Europe they call them mobile. You have P for phone and M for mobile. I made a film, and it played on mobile phones throughout the world. So I wanted to make something that, in the end, could be distributed on small screens, be it digital or mobile, but at the same time work as a feature film, because I have a feature film called The American Astronaut, which I've seen many times in sections on YouTube or other online formats, pieced in pieces. And so I wanted to make something that would be a feature film that was created episodically, that could be downloaded in segments, but at the same time was an entire story.
So it could play on TV, it could play as a feature film, it could play on your iPod.
Exactly. And the way the episode format has been working has been amazing. I was in Amsterdam a couple weeks ago, and the people were singing along with every time the theme song would come up. It has a 20-second theme song, which is like a reprise that comes in between each.
Kind of like what they did with ABBA whenever.
I had no idea. But people were singing along with it. But then when I went to London, people would laugh every time the reprise would come up, more so each time.
Deadpan humor in England there, tell you.
And people would applaud in between the episodes as well. So it was very much a live event.
So where are you from, actually?
Originally San Francisco, and then I moved to Chicago for a couple of years, but I've been living in New York and Brooklyn for the past 9 years.
But you give such an impression of being European.
But that, I have no idea why. If I cover the label, I will have a drink of beer.
And where is my beer? We'll toast to having a beer. And, you know, product placement excluded. Yeah, you know, tell us a little bit about where you come from cinematically and, artistically to get to where you are now.
Originally, I was a painter and a musician.
What kind of painting? A house painting, or was that art?
Both. House painting and fine house painting, I call it.
Fine house painting.
Yes. As well as portraits. I did a lot of portraits. And I perform music. I had a band called The Billionaire Show, and now I've got a band called American Astronaut, named after my first feature film. But I decided to put it together, so I made an animated short called Billionaire. And
what year was this?
92. Uh-huh. 92. And it's done well. It's still around.
So it's only been about 15 years that you've really launched yourself into the film industry.
Has it been 15?
Well, 92, 2002, 2009, well, maybe more.
Yeah, it's almost 20 years, yeah. Well, actually, I have to say, it took me 3 years to make it, so it's been about 20 years.
So what came right before Stingray Bob, and then...
Stingray
after,
Sam.
Stingray Sam. And what's going to be coming after him down the horizon?
Well, I've got a couple more feature films that I've written. One of them's being... it's going to be directed by a friend of mine who's a director. I don't know if I should say his name because it's a new thing. And I've also got one about a werewolf hunter, a very old man who hunts werewolves. I've been trying to get...
Yeah, the young ones just never make it.
Well, you know, he's old. He kills werewolves in a society where nobody believes in werewolves. And he knows that he doesn't have very long left, so he tries to find a young man to be his protege.
But yet, if he became a vampire or a werewolf himself, he could probably live for who knows how long.
But that would defeat his purpose.
As long as he became a werewolf hunter.
That's a different film.
Well, it's kind of like that guy who's half vampire and he kills the vampires, but with a samurai sword.
Yeah, as well, you know, it's like...
So you're going towards science fiction then, down the road.
Yeah, well...
Although Stingray Sam has nothing to do with science fiction.
Stingray Sam is a science fiction film. It's a musical space western.
Well, why don't you tell us a little bit about that, since we've heard a little bit about your future, your past, and let's hear about what's going on right now with Stingray Sam, because we want people to see this movie. We want them to go out and hunt it down, so to speak. I don't care if you have to go on the internet. I don't care if you have to go to the local Cineplex or wherever. You find Stingray Sam, you see Stingray Sam, okay? You need to. All episodes. Now, tell us about that.
Stingray Sam's doing very well in the festival circuit. I was because it's a science fiction, it's been embraced by science fiction and horror festivals. In Amsterdam, it kept going back and forth for first place with a wonderful film called Let the Right One In, which is doing very well. It's a favorite film among
I remember that movie, yes.
Yeah, and
it was about a little child and somebody you have to invite a vampire into your house and
and Stingray Sam kept going first place, then second place, and first place, and second place. With the audience.
It was jousting with the
it was indeed, which I was very surprised to see, and pleasantly surprised. But we came in a close second.
How long are each episode?
11 minutes.
Well, have you ever given a thought that, you know, maybe like a movie like Star Trek opening now, back in the day there was, I forget whose movie, Spielberg, somebody, where they had this intro little cartoon like they used to do in the old days. It was about 10, 11 minutes long, or a serial that they used to do. How about introducing that as an intro to a major film and create your name that way?
Another film festival in Florida presented it that way. They presented it as a feature, but at the end of their festival, and then through the entire festival they would place episodes at the beginning of other features.
Well, that's a great idea, and I think maybe you might make other features in the future where each one is 20 segments or whatever that can play 20 weeks, 1 week at a time in front of every blockbuster that comes along. I smell money. Ah, well, anyway, we're here with Corey McAbee. Thank you for having a beer with me, and my pleasure.
I stepped in money on the way here, so that's probably what you smell.
Well, listen, it's been really great being here at the Filmmakers Tent at the Maryland Baltimore Film Festival. It's yearly. You really need to be coming here instead of Sundance. Why be in the cold? You're not going to ski anyway. I think you need to be here in the heat, sweltering, have a sauna. We treat everybody right. We've got great food here in Baltimore, and now you have the big picture. Okay, this is Gallop and Gabe. We'll get back to you soon. We'll see if we can talk to
Gabe.
We'll see if we can find some other filmmakers that are almost as savvy as this man here, because obviously this man's on the top of his game, because he knows how to cast, he knows how to talk, and he knows how to buy somebody a beer. Thank you very much. We'll be back. Don't go away. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.